Hey guys, this is going to be your general singles love reading for the zodiac sign of Scorpio. So this is for the Scorpios that are currently not dealing with anyone that's currently looking for new love. This is going to be for the month of May. So we're going to take a look at Scorpio's current overall energies regarding love. We'll take a look at what challenges or blockages that you're currently facing in finding new love, and then we'll see what the to see if there's anyone new coming towards your way, you know, what their current overall energies are like, what they're like. Before we get started, those of you that haven't subscribed to my channel yet, hit the subscription button and the notification bell so that you guys could get up-to-date content that's being uploaded onto my channel. Give this video a thumbs up, like this video so that this message can circulate around to the individuals that need to hear this message. Leave a comment down in the comment section below if this message resonated with you. And those of you that are interested in booking a private personal reading with me, the link is in the description box below. All right, tell me about single Scorpio. What are their current overall energies regarding love here for these single Scorpios for May 2021? Overall energies for the single Scorpio here regarding love for May 2021. That's a lot. Oops. That was like half of the deck that fell onto my arm. Okay, we have the Knight of Cups on the bottom of the deck. So there you are, Scorpio. Let's see, we have the Fool, Aries. Aquarius energy, the Ten of Cups here, Ten of Swords, all right, the Chariot, Cancer energy, Temperance, Sagittarius energy, and the Two of Wands. So what is your current overall energies towards love? I feel like you're healing from heartbreak here. I feel like you're healing from a betrayal. You might have been married or been together with someone at some point, but I feel like you're not in this committal energy right now. I feel like you're trying to move forward with your healing. You might be caught in the rock and the hard place right now. Maybe there's a sense of wanting to go back or continue moving forward because you have this Two of Wands here. So let's get some more messages here for you, Scorpio. Tell me about this Fool here. The Fool and the Queen of Swords. We're doing Scorpio. Okay. So that is Libra, Aquarius, Gemini energy. Tell me about the Ten of Cups. You have the Knight of Wands here. You know, with this kind of Ten of Cups, I feel like you're just sort of happy where you're at. Just, you know, having a good time, I just feel like you're just not ready to commit right now because I still feel like you're healing from a painful ending. Now, will you push away new love if it came towards your way? I don't feel like you would, but I just feel like you might be a bit cautious. Tell me about the Ten of Swords. You got the Seven of Wands. Yeah, I feel like you might be a little bit cautious here because maybe the fear of possibly getting hurt again. Tell me about the Chariot. You have the Eight of Cups here. I feel like you don't believe in love. Yeah, I feel like you're walking away from it. I feel like there's this energy of maybe just being in like multiple unsuccessful relationships and they just never worked out. And I feel like you're losing some sort of hope or, you know, just not finding it successful. All right, tell me about Temperance. You have the Seven of Cups. Tell me about the Two of Wands. And the Emperor. So maybe there is this energy of trying to go back to an Emperor. Or just focusing on your healing here. Maybe focusing on other options. Maybe focusing on other things. You have the Queen of Pentacles on the bottom of this deck. So you might be just focusing on yourself, focusing on your money. Maybe there is this energy of like wanting to go back, but there's also this energy of, you know, just not believing in love anymore because you feel like it's not successful or that you've never been victorious in it. All right, we have the Fool being clarified by the Queen of Swords, the Ten of Cups being clarified by the Knight of Wands. Yeah, maybe a player hurt your feelings here, you know, broke your trust, something, painful ending. Ten of Swords being clarified by the Seven of Wands, the Chariot being clarified by the Eight of Cups. Temperance being clarified by the Seven of Cups and the Two of Wands being clarified by the Emperor. All right, let's take a look at the next question here. All right, tell me more about the Singles Scorpio. What are their current blockages? What are their current challenges here in finding new love for May 2021? Current blockages and challenges for Singles Scorpio in finding new love for May 2021. All right, let's see what's going on, Scorpio. Hierophant on the bottom of the deck, Taurus energy. We have the Eight of Swords. We have the Hermit. Yeah, I just feel like you're not really engaging with people. I just feel like you're caught in your own bubble. Just sort of in hiding. Ten of Wands. I feel like there's this energy of not letting go of this weight, not letting go of the past, maybe. Four of Swords. I feel like you might be in your head a lot. High Priestess, Cancer, Pisces energy, and the King of Cups. So there you are again. No, you only came, this is the only time you came up. But you could be in that Queen of Swords energy, just having your boundaries up here with someone or just with everyone. I feel like you're not trusting. Yeah, I feel like you just don't believe in love anymore. I'm really feeling that with this. Yeah, I feel like you might not believe in marriage because maybe some of you may have like some failed marriages or more than one failed marriage or commitment here. All right, let's see. Tell me about this Eight of Swords. Yeah, I just feel like the challenge here is really holding on to all this weight here that has happened to you in the past and really walking around with it, really believing that, you know, love doesn't exist or something like that. All right. Tell me about this Eight of Swords. What's going on with this Eight of Swords here? What's going on with this Eight of Swords? Oh. Eight of Swords, Seven of Cups. I don't know if you, I feel like there's this energy of like maybe daydreaming. Like, I just feel like you're in your head a lot. Maybe like going through the scenarios, like what you could have done better. What, yeah. Because I'm feeling like a commitment here that you had with someone completely ended. It was a painful ending. You had the Three of Swords and the Ten of Swords on the bottom of the deck. Yeah, I'm feeling like you're stuck in your head about just ruminating on like maybe what can you have done better, or like, you know, maybe like looking back at some of the red flags, if there were any red flags there. Tell me about the Hermit, the Moon, Cancer, Pisces energy. I really feel like you're hiding from the world. And, you know, and not really expressing your emotions, not expressing your pain outright. Yeah, I do feel like you're trying to heal from this, but it's gonna be a process. Yeah, I do feel like some, you know, some Scorpios do handle things, especially when it comes to this stuff. Maybe you know, it takes a little bit of time, a little time, which is okay. Tell me about the Ten of Wands. All right, you have the Sun here, Leo energy. Tell me about the Four of Swords and the Ace of Swords. So 4 plus 1 is 5. There's a sense of like, I feel like there's a sense of like convincing yourself like there's no such thing as true love or something like that, because as a result of like just being constantly hurt again over and over and over again. Tell me about the High Priestess. Six of Cups here. Yeah, not letting go of the past, holding on to the past. Really not, I feel like you don't, I feel like you're not really speaking to anyone about this. I feel like you're holding this in. All right, tell me about the King of Cups. And Three of Pentacles. Okay, we have the Hierophant here. Yeah, I'm really just getting this energy of not believing in love or not believing in marriage or it doesn't exist. I'm just feeling like there's a sense of holding on to the past and not letting it go. Sort of like thinking about things, thinking about past events and what you could have done to make things better, sort of thing. All right, we have the Eight of Swords being clarified by the Seven of Cups, the Hermit being clarified by the Moon. Just really keeping to yourself, yeah. Not really expressing your emotions a lot or at all. Ten of Wands being clarified by the Sun, Four of Swords being clarified by the Ace of Swords, and then we have the High Priestess being clarified by the Six of Cups, the King of Cups being clarified by the Three of Pentacles. Yeah, there's just a constant energy of ruminating over something here in the past. I don't know, I just feel like you might not really want to, I don't know, I feel like there's a sense of like giving up here. So, all right, let's see. Is there anyone new coming towards single Scorpio's way? What are their overall energies? What does single Scorpio need to know about this individual for May 2021? So the Ace of Wands jumped out when I was shuffling. One more shuffle. And the World flew out in the reverse. There's unfinished business here. I feel like you're seeking some sort of closure. Maybe this person left without closing things out properly. You know, this person hurt you and just ghosted you or something like that. The Fool on the bottom of the deck. You have the Fool right there. Five of Wands. Four of Wands. So you have Temperance again. I'm not really getting this other person's energy. This is more you. King of Pentacles. Okay, maybe this. Let's see. So we have a King to the Queen of Pentacles. So we have the Queen of Pentacles on the bottom of this deck here. And I'm just feeling like there's unfinished business. I don't know if you want to fight to get this back or this person wants to fight to get this back, but it just seems like there's some sort of unfinished business. Someone's still really passionate about someone. This is definitely, I feel like this is your energy though. All right, tell me about this Ace of Wands. Tell me about this Ace of Wands here. What's going on with this Ace of Wands? Ace of Wands, Three of Wands. So someone's yearning for something, still passionate about someone. Three plus one is four. So you have the Four of Wands here pretty much two times. Tell me about the World in reverse. Yeah, look at that. Unfinished business, wanting a second chance here. So this is someone else. So we're asking about the new person that's coming towards your way. So I'm feeling like an old person wants to come back. Tell me about the Four, Five of Wands, Seven of Wands. Tell me about the Four of Wands. You have the Queen of Cups here. So there is a masculine and a feminine energy here. Look at that. So we have the King to Queen of Cups, King to Queen of Pentacles. So we have a pair here. So this is like a strong soul tie or a twin flame. So I'm feeling like you had a lot of difficulty in your relationship with this individual. And I feel like you're ruminating about this past person or just the past and how you could have done things better here. So let's see. Tell me about Temperance. Six of Wands. Tell me about the King of Pentacles. And the Page of Pentacles. Someone wants to come in with an apology. But I'm just, Scorpio, I'm really feeling like this energy of you maybe giving up on this too. Because I feel like you don't trust that there's like true love out there. Because I feel like you've been hurt so many times by someone. But I feel like this person here is wanting to come back for a reconciliation. But I feel like there's going to be conflict here. I feel like someone's going to push this away. I feel like it's you. I feel like even though you might not be in this like happy energy, you're pretty much in this peaceful energy because you're by yourself. You're not fighting with someone. You're not arguing. There's no stress. You know, you're sort of like just by yourself. Yeah, I feel like someone wants to come in and heal the situation, but I don't know if you're going to be receptive of it. Ace of Wands being clarified by the Three of Wands. The World in reverse being clarified by Judgment. We have the Five of Wands being clarified by the Seven of Wands. The Four of Wands being clarified by the Queen of Cups. Temperance being clarified by the Six of Wands. And the King of Pentacles being clarified by the Page of Pentacles. So Scorpio, this is your singles love reading for May 2021. If this resonated, please like, share, comment, and subscribe, and I'll speak to you guys in the next one. Thanks.